on the 8s with meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
6:38, I wanted to start with a look over in Europe. Why? Well, look at this big circular cloud motion. It's a strong storm across the European continent. Look at some of these wind gusts. Brussels, 50 mile an hour, 89 mile an hour wind in Amsterdam. This is just in the last hour, the Isle of Wight, no, just off the coast of London, or off of England there, just south of London. 99 mile an hour winds. Yeah, quite a storm there. But for us, a little bit more on the way of calm weather. Not a bad looking day. We should get to near 60 after a pretty frosty cold start this morning. Then overnight tonight, a few more clouds. Won't be quite as chilly, but it'll be cool. 30s to around 40 degrees. Tomorrow looks like an okay day. More clouds around tomorrow and a little bit cooler, but okay. I think we get into the 50s tomorrow. Shave a few more off because of a cold front coming through. Looking live over Lancaster, it's all quiet at this hour. Pretty nice looking morning out there, but it's frosty cold. Down below, freezing in Lancaster, a little frost out there. Light west winds, so clear, calm, cold morning all across the valley. Most numbers in the 30s. 20s in some spots. Landisburg coming in 29. One less in Sealands Grove. York Thomasville Airport at 29 degrees. Ephrata and Lancaster right along that 31 mark. Nothing on the radar with clear skies. You don't expect to find anything on the radar, and we don't. Now, we pull out a little bit. Notice a little line of clouds up here. And that little tail is a weak cool front. There's also a little bit of precipitation, a little weather maker over parts of the southeast. Neither really going to bother us. High pressure's in control. Now, this front is going to move through here probably later on this afternoon into the evening hours and bring in a little bit of a cooler northerly flow of air. And we do think some clouds will be along this front as we get into tomorrow morning for a little while. Predictor's not showing a lot of those clouds. What happens, I think, is high pressure builds off the coast. We get more of an easterly flow of air, and that brings in more moisture probably, not only tomorrow, but more likely tomorrow night heading into Wednesday morning. Could be a little touch of light rain or drizzle around. But here comes a warm front. That is going to start to warm it up as it heads eastbound over the next couple of days and into the end of the week. Could bring some showers with it, especially as we get into Thursday morning. Best bet for rain probably comes for the first half of Friday with a cold front. This is going to be a pretty good strong storm, too. In the meantime, ahead of that first cold front, we get to 61 degrees today. That's not bad. Then overnight tonight, dropping in the 30s to near 40 degrees. Not as frosty cold. Tomorrow, a little cooler. We shave a few degrees off because, yeah, the cool front going through and a few more clouds around. Right back up close to 60, but again, it may start a little damp on Wednesday. Thursday, same story. Then I think it's breezy. It's pretty warm. Again, it could be a shower or two around, particularly in the morning, I think. Maybe a few by the evening for trick-or-treaters, but a better chance of some showers, maybe even some thunderstorms. Sounds like spring to me, coming through on Friday morning before it cools down over the weekend. Wouldn't surprise me if Thursday night we don't get out in the 60s. Oh. Could start pretty warm on Friday morning.
I would say so. That's a big difference from this morning, where it's like low 30s. Yeah. All right, Joe, thank you. Well, coming up, it is 8:30.